Hello and welcome back to Raji. And there. We just came into a new place. And I don't know how to get up there. Woohoo! Okay.
Mahabalasura has brought war upon the mystics. His own people.
It was inevitable. He tried to lead them, but his arrogance took him too far.
Raji must be careful. He may still have supporters amongst them.
As you say, it is war. And in war, all...
Beware, Raji. These creatures are bred for quickness and stealth.
They are weapons of war. In another circumstance, that might please you, Durga, goddess of war.
But not these. These are demons.
No! Okay. I was in the wrong angle, I wanted to say.
Trust these mystics, or their chief. Mahabalasura was one of them once. They have been separated from humanity for far too long.
The mystics are a part of...
Come on! Why? That was just mean. I cannot do something else than turn.
I do not trust these mystics, or their chief. Mahabalasura was one of them once. They have been separated from humanity for far too long.
The mystics are a part of Lord Shiva's balance in the world. The humans are weakened and the demons strong. A balance must be restored.
Surely now Lord Shiva must act. Look at the damage Mahabalasura has caused, and may yet cause.
What makes you think Shiva does not act? What do you think brought Raji when she was most needed? Why do you think that her brother Guru was the one to be taken?
Okay, what just happened here? Yay, we got a new orb. Okay. but I don't know. Do I have to jump? Can't. Okay. I don't exactly know where to go. Do I have to go there?
No.
Okay. I am not quite sure. I came from there. And it's very, like, I cannot jump there. No. So this cannot be the right path. Oh, I need to sit differently. I can't go more up. Where to go? I don't quite know. I'm quite confused right now. Okay, a second. Okay. I was correct, but I was just not good in the angle. Have to wait until she is like reaching out her hand, otherwise it's really difficult to find out the right angle. Yeah, come on. Annoying. Only because of the stupid angle. Okay.
That is a demon battle totem, a foul thing, which summons a multitude of creatures. Raji must beware.
I am confused. I killed him so easily. And others are like fighting really hard. Gameplay controls. That's so weird. I think I play on the easiest mode. Yeah, it's fine.
Was that your best?
No, we will not be separated. He stays with me. We will face together whatever is to come.
So they wanted to separate them.
Of Lord Shiva acting. This is his shrine. It is no coincidence that Raji finds herself here.
Time will tell.
Okay. Right, now we go. Yeah, would you please? Oh, I hear something really good sounding. Cool, yeah, okay. Now I died. No problem before. But okay.
Lord Shiva. Okay. You'll be summoned me to this place. How may I stop this war and save my brother? Mahadev, I will find my way.
Oh, ah. Okay, so this is ice, but I kind of want to stay with the fire. I wonder why Shiva's element is ice. I always wondered, but I also wondered that about, because in that Ifrit is fire in Final Fantasy. I can understand that because it's a fire, like it's a djinn. But why Shiva stands for ice? Why is
the
that?
The child, her brother. He has spent much time with Mahabalasura. I cannot see his plan for the boy.
He is a twisted creature. He will use Golu to defeat Raji, to use her love against her. She must be careful.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, that was, yeah, okay. Okay.
the sun will decide the fate of many a man. Baba, what do our ancestors' words mean?
Okay. So they were considered born in the shadow?
It is the birth of Biplan, an aspect of Lord Shiva. When Biplan was just a young boy, his father Dadichi gave his own bones in sacrifice to the Devas to defeat the Asuras. Biplan asked the Devas why his family should suffer such bad fortune, and they told him it was simply due to the alignment of the planets. Biplan was furious at this fate and cursed Shani of the ringed planet, whose celestial home started to fall from the sky. The Devas interceded, pleading for mercy on Shani, for Biplan to lift the curse. Biplan agreed on the condition that Shani's position would no longer bring trouble on anyone of less than 16 years old.
Okay, I don't understand that. Kinda. Someone that is under 16 years old is not troubled by the stars? And fate?
This is the marriage of Shiva to Sati, which angered Sati's father, Daksha, greatly. Daksha snubbed the girl and insulted Shiva in public. Sati was unable to bear it and threw herself into the sacrificial fire. Shiva fell into a great rage and pulled a lock of hair from his brow, lashing the ground with it. Veerabhadra, fierce warrior of Shiva, who destroyed Daksha and extinguished his fire. Even I could not stop him.
I mean, why Daksha insulted Shiva? I mean, was he mad?
The birth of Ashwatthama, gifted to his father Drona after many, many years of penance, born with a magical gem in his forehead that made him a mighty warrior. After Drona was killed through trickery, Ashwatthama issued a challenge to Arjuna. Both warriors used mantras to create mighty world-destroying weapons. Arjuna was wise and withheld his weapon, but Ashwatthama did not, instead directing it at Uttara, Arjuna's daughter-in-law, utterly destroying the lineage of the Pandavas. For that action, Krishna cursed Ashwatthama and cut the gem from his forehead. For thousands of years, he roamed the forests of the world with blood and pus oozing from his injury. It is rumored he walks there still.
Okay, what the heck? What?
There was a time when I was to take from upon the earth as Rama. Lord Shiva was greatly pleased and wished to travel with my avatar in my journey to aid me. But Parvati begged him to stay with her. There was a devoted king, Kesari, of the monkey people, who prayed to Shiva for a child. And so, as a means to assist me, and as boon to Kesari, Shiva was born as Kesari's son and became Hanuman, who was helper to my Rama.
Okay. His wife asked him to stay and he was born as a boon? What? That's actually interesting.
The mystic homes, they burn. Golu, you are surely too clever to have been hurt. You must be safe. I pray that you're safe.
Okay, we cannot go back.
This will be difficult for her to see, I think. War is not pretty.
It is destruction and death and bone and blood. It will not be pleasant, yet she must learn the extent of her enemy's malice.
Wait a second. Aha! I see.
No, please, poor people. Why could I not come sooner? I could have saved them. What monstrous person did this?
Thank you.
She must know what Mahabalasura is capable of.
I am sorry, Raji.
Her quest is no longer just for her brother, but for all who suffer this evil.
Okay, so okay.
The entire village of the Mystics was under threat. This conqueror would stop at nothing. Destroy centuries of history and learning. The Mystic Chieftain was forced to give up the scroll he had kept secret for so long.
Okay, and I say goodbye on this place, and we will see us in the next episode. Thank you so much for watching.